Hi friends, good day to all. Today's topic we are going to discuss about stress analysis of corner angled rocket. So this is the geometry we need to construct it and says mechanical EPDL and to obedient the constraint at fixed this end and apply the uniform pressure load at this two end. So we need to find out the stress distribution on this corner angle bracket for the uniform pressure load. Let's discuss. Go to ANSYS mechanical EPDL product launcher. Choose which directory, where the directory all the files need to be stored. So you need to choose the directory where all the file needs to be stored and give name as corner angle bracket and give run and then give the title of your project. So this will be corner angle bracket, corner angle bracket, and then go to preference, structural analysis, and then go to preprocessor, element type, add any delete, add, and this should be a plane element. So the plane element should also have the thickness. In the geometry they mention the thickness of the bracket will be 10 mm, and this should be a plane element. You can choose plane 183 element, 8 node 183, give OK and then go to option and then enable the element behavior because that plane has the thickness. So give plane stress thickness, give OK, element behavior K3, enable the plane stress thickness, give OK and then close. Next go to real constant, add edit delete and then add the plane 183 element and it has the thickness 10 mm, and then give OK and then close. And then next we need to define the material property. The material property given is this is the A36 steel and it has the Young's modulus 200 gigapascal, that is 2 into e to the power 5, and then Poisson ratio is 0.27. go to material properties, material model, structural, linear, elastic, isotropic, and then give the Young's modulus 2 e to the power 5. And then Poisson ratio should be 0.27 and then give OK. Next go to section, sorry not, go to modeling and then create areas, rectangle. So here you have the three options to generate the rectangle by two corner, by center and corner, by dimensions. So I go with by dimension. It is very simple to generate the rectangle. I just generate the rectangle of whole size, that is 600 × 400, and subtract a small rectangle by creating inside it, that is 400 × 200. So I just first give the larger rectangle, which has x1 will be 0, y1 will be 600, y1 will be 0, y2 will be 400, and then give apply. And then you got the rectangle, and then you need to create another rectangle. Here x1 will be 0, y1 will be x2 will be 400, and then x2 will be 400, y1 will be 0, y2 will be 200, and then give OK. A smaller rectangle created. We need to subtract this rectangle from this larger rectangle. Go to operate boolean E boolean. Okay, we need to go to operate boolean, add, sorry, subtract areas, large area first and then give apply, and then smaller area second. So the smaller area will be deleted. Next we need to create the semicircle at this end of the bracket. So how we create it? We again go to create areas, circle, solid circle, that we need to give the center of the circle. This will be 200 and this will be 300. X will be 0, Y will be 300. And the radius of the circle should be 100 because the diameter is 200. And then give OK. We create a circle and then we need to create another circle here. X will be, this will be 400 and this will be 500. X will be 500, Y will be 0 and then radius will be 100 and then give OK. So we create a radius and then here we need to do the fillet operation. What is the radius of the fillet? This will be 50. So again go to lines. For generating the fillet, go to create lines, line fillet. So select the horizontal line and then select the vertical line. Give the fillet radius as 50. Then give OK. The fillet will be created, fillet line. And then you need to fill this empty area. Go to area, arbitrary, by lines. So select the lines where the fillet done. Give OK. So area will be created. Now we need to add all these areas. OK. Go to operate, boolean, add areas. Just give pickle or else individually select the areas. Give pickle, all the areas will be added. And then next we need to create a hole here. Go to create areas, circle, solid circle. So the X will be 0, Y will be 300, radius will be 50. And then give OK, a circle created here. And then similarly, X will be 500, Y will be 0, radius will be 50, and then give OK, another circle created here. And then next, go to operate, boolean, subtract, areas. So first you need to select the large area, and then give OK, and then select the small area, which is you want to delete it. So I create a hole here. Okay, next what we need to do, we need to mesh the corner angle bracket. Go to meshing. Okay, go to mesh tool, select the areas and then pick call. I want to mesh entire area, just give pick call. The element length, just give minimum value. I just give each and every element length will be 1 and then give OK and then again choose mesh tool, mesh. Okay, mesh area, pick area, all the area should be meshed. Give OK, it will be meshed. Wait for a moment. Okay, if I give the finite element size that has created a problem. This is academic study version ANSYS, so that is not accepted by ANSYS academic study version. So I just give the element size a just little bit larger. I just give the element length will be 10 mm and then give OK. Again choose mesh tool and then mesh, all the area should be meshed. Pick all, so all the areas gets meshed. If you want to refine it, go to mesh tool and then choose refine elements, pick all, and then just one minimal. Okay, so don't give too much maximum level, that is too much fine. Just give the minimum value, that's enough. Okay, the discretization will be very fine compared to previous. Next we need to apply the loads. Go to loads, analysis type, new analysis, close the mesh tool, and this will be the static analysis. Give OK, then go to define loads settings, sorry, go to apply structural displacement on lines. You should go on lines. So this will be rigidly fixed. What is say here, the fixed pin dia 100 mm hole. Okay, so this should be rigidly fixed. And then select all the inner edges. This will be rigidly fixed. Then give OK and the all degrees of freedom. This element plane 183 element has only 2 degrees of freedom, UX and UY. All the degrees of freedom will be 0, and then give OK. This will be rigidly fixed, and here will be supported by a rod. This will be give the uniform pressure load at the semicircle portion at start, and then end it has the 50 newton per square mm. At end, at the middle portion, it has 5000 newton per square mm. Go to pressure, choose on lines. So select the first line and then give OK, and then wait a minute. So go to structural, pressure on lines, select the first line and then give apply, and this should be if the value, then value press stored 50 and then 5000 J node. I node will be 50, J node will be 5000, and then give apply, and then next here the second line, and then apply, and then here at the starting point 5000, ending point with 50, and then give OK. Go to plot and then multi plot. You can see the constraint given to the problem. Rigid support and then load apply at the another end. So next we complete all the load applying procedure. Next go to solution, solve, current LS, give OK. The solution will be done. And then next we go to check the result. Go to general post processor, plot results, deformed shape, deform plus undeformed shape. You can get the deformed result. Maximum deformation is 187.898 mm. So go to file, report generator, and then choose where the results need to be stored. Choose the result folder in the directory, and then give OK, and then take up the snap for your report generation. It is deformed shape. Deformed shape result, and then close it. Okay. And then you can go to contour plot, nodal solution, degrees of freedom, displacement vector sum. You can get the displacement vector sum. So what is the maximum displacement? 187.898. Here we have the maximum deformation occurred. Then go to file, go to report generator, go to append OK, and then generate the result. DOF vector sum. Then give OK. Then close it. Next, as usual, to check the stress threshold, go to nodal solution, stress, warn me stress, give OK. Then you can get the maximum stress 0.27855.5 newton per mm square, which is occurred at this support, rigid support. And then you can generate the file, report generator, go to append OK, then take up the snap, and then give stress results, and then give OK. Then next, if you want to check out the simulation, go to plot control, go to animate, deformed results, choose the stress, and then choose warn me stress sequence, and then give OK. You can get the stress result. If you want to sequence result as your report, go to report generator, append OK, and then I want to the animation capture. This should be deformed result. Oh, not you need to deformed result, give OK. This should be the stress, one miss stress sequence, give OK. All the thing will be captured and it will be stored on your result directory. You can go and check the result directory. self file animation sequence ones. So these are the how the stress deformation will be takes place. Step by step sequence will be captured, each and every time frame will be captured. And then you can check what is the each and every time step, what is the value will be changed, and then that can be noted. Okay, if you want to see the three-dimensional animation, go to plot control, style, size and shape of the element, enable the display of elements, you can get the 3D view. So we can see the thickness also. Go to plot control, animate, deformed results, degrees of freedom vector sum, use them, you can get the degrees of freedom vector sum result also. Thank you all. Save all your files.